Jamaica Society for the Blind presents Inspire, our Black History Month feature, where we look at the work of the blind and visually impaired and how it contributes to our history. We present Inspire.
This week, we will place our focus on Senator Dr. Floyd Emerson Morris. Despite his blindness and the struggles that come along with it, he has become successful and an example to everyone that blindness does not prevent you from having a full life. Floyd Emerson Morris was born on the 23rd of July 1969 in Bailey's Vale in the parish of St. Mary, Jamaica. He was born to parents Lloyd Morris, who was a fireman, and Mother Jemita Pryce, who was a dressmaker. Morris started to lose his eyesight due to glaucoma in grade 9 while he was attending St. Mary High School, and it progressively deteriorated over 6 years. He speaks of falling into deep depression after his vision loss. It had felt like the world was coming to an end. However, the resilient Floyd Morris eventually arose from that darkness and became determined to prosper. Morris left St. Mary High in grade 11 without any qualifications, but that did not prevent him from setting out to achieve his goals. He went into poultry farming with the help of his mother, who was a supporter of the People's National Party, PNP. His mom, Jemita Pryce, would get contracts from the Member of Parliament, Horace Clark. When the PNP fell out of power in the 1980s, Jemita's source of funding dried up. Despite the odds, Floyd continued his poultry business, and when the PNP regained power in 1989, his Member of Parliament, Horace Clark, gave him enough money to expand his business from 30 to 200 chickens and vegetables on 27 acres of land. Morris decided that he would employ persons from the rivaling Jamaica Labour Party, JLP, to ensure that if the PNP fell out of power again, he would still get help from the other side. Although the business was doing well, and despite his disability, Morris decided that he wanted to get a good education. So his first stop was at the Jamaica Society for the Blind, the JSB, in 1991. Morris traveled to Kingston and visited the Jamaica Society for the Blind. While being there, Morris learned Braille. He then decided that he would further his studies and attend university. Morris then enrolled at the Michael Evening College, where he spent 2 years getting himself qualified. He then applied and was accepted by the University of the West Indies, UWI. He received a Bachelor of Arts in Mass Communication. He then returned and got a Master of Philosophy in Government and later his doctorate in the same field. In his last year of undergraduate studies at the UWI, Prime Minister P.J. Patterson came to the university to give a speech. In the question and answer segment, Morris criticized the Prime Minister's education policy. Floyd then realized he had an interest in politics, so he joined the People's National Party. Through this organization, he traveled to Cuba to attend the 1997 World Youth Congress. At this Congress, Floyd attracted attention as a skilled public speaker. When he returned from Cuba, Floyd began giving speeches for the PNP in aid of victory in the 1997 general elections. After the PNP's victory in that election, Horace Clark and other members of Parliament lobbied Prime Minister P.J. Patterson to make Morris a senator. In 1998, Prime Minister P.J. Patterson appointed Floyd Morris to the Senate, and he made history by becoming Jamaica's first blind senator. From 2001 until 2007, Floyd served as a Minister of State in the Ministry of Labor and Social Security. He served in the Senate until 2007, when the PNP lost the election. He regained his Senate seat in 2012 when the PNP won the election. Morris was appointed President of the Senate on the 17th of May 2013. He was nominated by the Leader of Government Business and seconded by the Leader of Opposition Business. Morris's time in Parliament has not been without its challenges, though. In 2017, Senator Floyd Morris walked out of the Senate in protest against the blatant disregard for his disability. They wanted to start a debate on an act, but Senator Morris would have none of it. He asked that the sitting be adjourned and that the document be converted into a format which was accessible to him. The Leader of Government Business at the time made some disparaging remarks to Morris, which were later withdrawn, but there was still an insistence for the debate to continue. At that point, Senator Morris walked out of the sitting. Senator Dr. Morris is now the director at the Center for Disability Studies at the UWI Mona Camp. He is a radio announcer and is CARICOM's special rapporteur on disability. Additionally, Morris has been married now for 7 years to his partner, Shelly-Ann Gale, and is a devoted Seventh-day Adventist. To learn more about the life of Senator Dr. Morris, you can purchase his autobiography called By Faith, Not By Sight, the autobiography of Jamaica's first blind senator. Here is a motivational word from Senator Dr. Morris.
I have seen oftentimes or people complain about what they do not have and the little that they have, not realizing that the power and the capacity is within them to transform their lives and accomplish anything that they want. It is just for them to be the best that they can be in whatsoever sphere of life. If you are a carpenter, you must aspire to be the best carpenter. If you are a chauffeur, you must aspire to be the best chauffeur. If you are a cook, you must aspire to be the best cook.
Let's celebrate the life of one of our greatest achievers, Senator Dr. Floyd Emerson Morris.
So there we have it, Black history through the eyes of the blind. Their work and their deeds shaping the lives of a people. So join us next time for another in the series, Inspire, a production of the Jamaica Society for the Blind.